Did you catch the tricky trap here with this absolute value? For this interval negative pi to pi, remember that with a definite integral, we're adding the areas under the curve. But the problem is that on that interval, if this original function was ever negative, and now you are making it positive with the absolute value, and you add all the areas as if everything was above the x-axis, you're going to get this wrong on your exam. So how do we figure out if that function was ever negative? Well, it's simple, right? We find its roots. And so I'm going to pull out this x here, and then I'm going to simplify this expression further by factoring it some more. And by inspection, it's really easy to see that x is going to be either 0, 2, or negative 1 to make the output a value of 0. And if you remember from pre-calculus, around the roots, because it's a continuous function, we have a behavior change. We're either going from a positive output to a negative or vice versa. So to find out where and on what intervals this function was negative before the absolute value happens, we need to break this up into separate parts. So you start with your lower limit of integration here, negative pi, because it's the leftmost side of the intervals. And then I'm going to take my most negative root that I found above, negative 1. And so I'm going to look at this interval and just choose one sample value inside of it to test. I'll go with negative 3 because it's easy to work with. And when I plug it into the original function f of x, we'll see that it's less than 0. And so next I would move on to the next interval from negative 1 to 0, because 0 was another root that we found. And by plugging in x equals negative 1/2 as an example value, f of x is greater than 0. And you get the idea, right? Because now we try the interval 0 to 2, and I'm going to plug in a value of x as 1, and that's going to tell me that f of x is less than 0. And then finally, you don't want to forget about the upper limit of integration, right? That has its own interval from the uppermost root of 2 that we found up to the upper limit of integration pi. And so I'm going to choose 3 here as my test value and plug it in. And once again, f of x is actually greater than 0. So what's the point of this? Well, now what we can do is, based on these behavior changes of f of x, we can rewrite the original function without an absolute value sign, because that's a headache. And instead, we can treat it as this piecewise function. So anywhere where f of x was greater than 0, we know that the absolute value did nothing. It's not going to change the output. So we can just write the function as you see in these two cases. However, in the cases where f of x was originally negative, the absolute value sign is kind of like multiplying the function by a negative 1. So we can put these two negative 1s outside of the function as you see here. Now, the reason why this is important is because the original problem I gave you is a trick in disguise. You can treat it now as adding 4 separate definite integral problems where each one is using one of these intervals. And that's going to make sure that when you add them up, that your signs are correct. So your homework, and you tell me below what your answer is.